every now and then you will need to recharge your car's AC system. All you got to do is to buy the correct refrigerant and the refrigerant's specific pump. So the first step is to open your car's hood, where you should see a sticker which would give you the name of the refrigerant that you should use, and you could only use that refrigerant. There are only two refrigerants. One is called R-134A and the other is R-1234YF. My car is Toyota Yaris and the refrigerant that it requires is R-134A. So make sure to check the right refrigerant for your car's exact model. You would also need to buy a pump to pump the refrigerant into your system. Once again, each refrigerant has its own pump. You cannot interchange the pumps for different refrigerants. The pump is actually called digital trigger and gauge, and it would give you clear instructions throughout the whole process of filling your refrigerant. As you can see, the pump that I bought is for R-134A only. So to refill your car's refrigerant, you need to first start your engine. Then turn on your aircon and make sure the direction of wind is forward. Put your fan to maximum and recirculating air. And finally, set the temperature to the lowest. Check the temperature and let it run for at least 3 minutes. Also, make sure your AC compressor is running. Now open your hood and secure it. Before refilling, we need to first wear protective glasses and safety gloves. My car engine's cover is obstructing my view, so I just take it out. Now you would need to find your low side pressure port. It should be located on an aluminium tube between the compressor and the evaporator. It is the larger of the two tubes and it is located in here. Remove the valve protection cap by unscrewing it. In order to turn on the gauge for the first time, you need to pull out this plastic film from here and then the gauge would turn on. Luckily, the gauge has got long enough hose, so all you got to do is to push in the hose's head onto this valve and then it would lock up. So once you connect it, then you need to check the readings on your digital display. Here you could get 3 different diagnostics, such as pressure is low, squeeze trigger to fill. Pressure is good, fill until vent air is cold. Do not overfill. Caution, pressure exceeding recommended levels. See instructions. In my case, I got a reading saying pressure is good, fill until vent air is cold. So all we got to do now is to connect our refrigerant cylinder to the gauge. First, remove the cap from the cylinder, shake the cylinder for some time before connecting, and simply screw in the cylinder into the gauge. Make sure you hold the cylinder upright as much as you can. Before start filling, make sure to check the current pressure. And now we are ready to fill in the refrigerant by pressing the trigger lever. While you're holding the lever, keep shaking the cylinder. It won't display the pressure while you're squeezing the trigger, and it would say filling release trigger in 15 seconds. To read pressure. If your pressure was already high, don't keep holding the trigger. Leave it for some time, then read your pressure and make sure it is not exceeding the recommended level before squeezing the trigger again. And each time after filling the refrigerant, go inside your car and check your air conditioner temperature and see whether you're getting cold enough air. And each time after releasing the trigger, check your pressure and make sure it is not exceeding the recommended level. If your air condition is still not cold enough, but you have exceeded the recommended pressure, then you should stop refilling the refrigerant. So I filled the refrigerant until the pressure bar reached just before the alert level. In order to unlock the head, you need to pull from the bottom of the head. By just pulling it, you would not be able to take it out. So in order to release it, you need to pull it like this, the way I'm showing in here, by putting two of your fingers on the either sides and then pushing it upwards and then pulling it out. In this way, you could easily release the head. Now screw back the valve's cap, put the engine cover back if you got one, close your hood, and now you get nice cool air coming from your air conditioner.